All right, guys, here back with another post-game recap video from Neil Patterson Stadium on this Friday night. Different post-game recap because, Ben, the result's a little different from what we've seen in Neil Patterson Stadium this year. That's right. This was the first time in over a year that the Cowgirls had come away with a defeat on their home territory right here in Stillwater. Tonight's result, a 2-1 defeat against the Texas TCU Horned Frogs. And Sam, this TCU Horned Frogs team coming in at 12 in the nation. Obviously, right here, the Cowgirls are at 4. So it was a high-powered game. The TCU, it showed, right? TCU was getting quality opportunities all night long. Honestly, with TCU scoring the equalizer at late in the second half, it almost felt like a matter of time, right? Obviously, to score an equalizer, they had to have a deficit, and Hannah Webb for the Cowgirls contributed to that deficit. Webb, who's a wingback / defender on this team, scored her first ever goal. She's a senior this year, but scored her first ever goal on a beautiful shot on the far side of the field in the first half. It was definitely a beauty from the corner of the box, struck it well, and placed it right out of the dive of Emily Alvarado for the TCU Horned Frogs goalkeeper. Alvarado played well in this game, notching save after save that really would have put this game away, but with her stellar play, she kept the Horned Frogs in it. And then TCU, couldn't cash in on chances early, but late in the game and in the very first part of overtime, they scored and ended up coming away with the victory. Ben, how did overtime play out?
Well, and I'll say, Alvarado, she played spectacular, but that was to be expected. She's one of the premier goaltenders in the Big 12, a member of the Mexican national team, so certainly a challenge the Cowgirls knew they were going to have to face going up there. But in overtime, you mentioned how Hannah Webb scored her first goal. Brandi Peterson of the Horned Frogs also scored her first ever career goal. Only, 34 seconds into overtime. She made a super quick run right down the middle of the field, rolled a right-footed shot into the corner of the goal. And Emily Plotz, she could have been a superhuman, and I don't think she would have gotten to that. It was a tough save. Certainly kind of a shocker, right? TCU small section here in Neil Patterson Stadium went crazy. It almost felt like this game, the result, it kind of felt like TCU maybe deserved to be winning, or at least they didn't deserve a shutout loss. But to have TCU flip the game on its head so quickly, notch two goals late, like Ben said, the game-winning goal just 34 seconds into the first golden goal overtime period, kind of a stunner. And, this game just didn't turn out the way anyone expected, especially the Cowgirls being the number 4 team in the nation. Their first home loss this season and for quite a while. It'll be interesting to see where the AP poll slides in the coming week and where everything shakes out. But quite a game here in Neil Patterson Stadium on this beautiful Friday night. The Cowgirls, I guess, are now at 3-1-1 on this young season. Still a lot of soccer to be played. A lot of Big 12 games left on their schedule, so they'll certainly be hoping to bounce back. For the Ocali, I'm Ben Hutchens. Here is my brother, Sam Hutchens.